we have a brand called It's Better in the Bahamas. What we're doing now is beginning to tell people what's better in the Bahamas.
I think the Bahamas has a very bright future. There are a lot of changes that are happening, and great changes. We see that across infrastructure, we see that across the financial services industry.
Constant evolution. The entire Bahamas is going through that. We want to be ahead of the curve.
We have a very, very attractive environment where the opportunities are endless.
It's somewhere where you can live, work, and play. So, you know, it's not just sea and sand, but we are much more than that.
I would say it's warm and inviting. There's lots of people that you can talk to of different nationalities that are all right here doing business in the Bahamas.
Of course, you have all the infrastructure that is needed in terms of communication, in terms of roads, in terms of healthcare.
Generally, it's a very, very good place to live. You know, the culture is great, the weather is just amazing. It's paradise, and aside from paradise, it's paradise filled with opportunities waiting ripe for the picking.
I'd like to say there's no place like the Bahamas, not simply because of the natural beauty of our islands, but also because one would not expect to find the level of sophistication, the quality of life that we have here in the Bahamas.
The Bahamas offers more than most countries that I can possibly think of, and there's no mistake that it also happens to be the most beautiful country in the world.
The Bahamas is in a unique cultural, historic, and geographic position. At one point in 1492, unified the old world and the new world. This was the beginning of a new conversation. And we think at the dawn of the 21st century, the Bahamas still has an incredible role to play on the world stage in that conversation.
The Bahamas, 700 islands, rocks, and keys, covers 100,000 square miles of the Atlantic Ocean. And so this vast expanse needs to be connected back to the backbone. So I sometimes refer to BTC as the glue that holds the Bahamas together. Intra-island as well as inter-island, the connectivity is all by fiber optic cables.
We are very aware of the realities of modern day business and modern day communications, and we are embracing them. You know, your smart home, your smart office, the way to be able to do your business wherever you are.
BTC has to be on the cutting edge, always world class. When the tourists come or when the investor comes, I want them to feel and experience the kind of technology that they experience in London and in New York.
We've made a huge investment to connect all of our islands.
You know, the ports are the gateway to the economy, and so you have to make sure that that port infrastructure is competitive. FDI, or foreign direct investment, every second of every day, it's circling the globe. What we've done is we've invested in technology, in facilities, to make sure that that FDI, as it runs around the globe and it stops in Nassau, it looks at our facility and says, they're going to help me, they're not going to hurt me. Our investments in our port infrastructure is helping attract FDI. We are working closely with Ministry of Finance and with Bahamas Customs from the IT standpoint through this ESW. Our IT systems interface with, you know, the carriers around the world. It interfaces with Bahamas Customs. The trader simply sits down at their PC and is able to submit their entry to customs, submit their invoices to whatever other additional documentation, and they do it all electronically. The ESW is going to bring transparency, equity, accountability to the business environment.
Well, the Bahamas is a premier financial center, and we have been in the business for many years. We provide the products and services which the clients are looking for. We are responsive to their needs. We are a clean, compliant jurisdiction. where people can safely come and do business in an environment where they know that the regulations will cause them to be in compliance internationally. In order for us to do that, we have instituted AML-CFE, which is the Anti-Money Laundering and Counter-Financing of Terrorism. We have also signed 33 TIAs, where we have agreements for the exchange of information. Beyond that, we've successfully been able to implement FATCA, an intergovernmental agreement between the United States and the Bahamas in terms of tax information exchange. And last but not least, we are now implementing the automatic exchange of information on the common reporting standard, which is being required by the OECD. We've done all of that, and we will continue to monitor whatever the regulatory requirements are for us to remain a safe, compliant jurisdiction over the years. We know that the goalposts will continue to move as we go along, but we know that that is part of being a premier financial center, which the Bahamas really is.
We offer the full range of financial services products: trust, funds, insurance, private wealth management, the full range. And delivering or providing those services are many of the members of the Bahamas Financial Services Board, a unique public-private sector partnership where industry and government come together to collaborate, creating greater international awareness about the Bahamas as a financial center. The Bahamas has a strong value proposition as an international financial center. We believe that our strengths are our people, certainly our wonderful geographic location, our strong regulatory framework, and yes, a commitment to innovation to respond to the changing landscape. So as it relates to anti-money laundering, counter-financing of terrorism, and generally this spirit of transparency and cooperation that exists internationally, the Bahamas has demonstrated its commitment to being responsible.
Insurance companies have been in the Bahamas for over 100 years, so we have quite a high penetration of insurance throughout the Bahamas. It plays a very important role in the economy. I'd say that it relates to about 8 or 9% of GDP, both domestically and internationally. The Insurance Commission is responsible for ensuring the strength, viability, and protection of the insurance market in the Bahamas. It is both prudential and a market conduct regulator. We look to ensure that companies are solvent, and that their market practices are appropriate. At the Insurance Commission, we are aware of all of the innovations within the insurance industry, and we can react quite quickly and nimbly to these changing needs of our investors.
CIBC First Caribbean International Bank is a leading full-service relationship bank which spans across 17 different countries in the English and the Dutch-speaking Caribbean. The bank offers three major line of businesses: retail and business banking, corporate and investment banking, and wealth management. The vision of CIBC First Caribbean is to be a leader in client relationships, delivering banking that fits the lives of our clients. We offer traditional products and services, but we also customize products to meet our clients' needs. We also have a very highly qualified and knowledgeable staff and team who understand the value and the importance of delivering high-quality products and services.
One of the most beautiful aspects of the Bahamas is the interconnectivity between the islands, where you can get in a boat and you can go from island to island.
Moving around the Bahamas is not difficult at all. There's mail boats and fast ferries that service a lot of these islands on a daily basis. So getting from island to island is a breeze.
Well, the Family Islands, you know, they're our crown jewels. They have the pristine waters. They have beautiful white sand. And so there is an opportunity in terms of those boutique hotel properties or even the larger resort properties in some of these select family islands. Thank you.
This is a country made up of large and small islands that are spread across 100,000 square miles of the most beautiful waters anywhere. The University of the Bahamas system is very, very fortunate in that we consider the entire country our campus. This year, we've actually fulfilled one of our founding fathers' biggest dreams. Sir Lyndon Oscar Pindling, who was the first Prime Minister of the Bahamas, he knew back then the transitioning to a University of the Bahamas was going to be the key to further development of the people of the Bahamas as we grow as a nation.
As it relates to the youth of the Bahamas, where technology has taken us in the world, there's a lot of opportunities. A lot of the businesses that exist all now need to modernize their equipment, their way of doing business. There's a lot of need for apps, websites. We have the adequate infrastructure. There's Wi-Fi, there's fast internet all throughout the Bahamas.
We are building a technology innovation lab that's supported by one of our larger telecommunications corporation companies.
So that the students at the University of the Bahamas will have a platform to do Android apps or to do iOS apps. And that is where creativity and innovation is required. E-commerce, e-medicine, e-education, all those things must come to the forefront. The plan is to make New Providence the first smart island in the Caribbean.
I'm sure that I'm biased, but the Bahamas has got to be the most beautiful place on earth.
You can come every summer for the next 30 or 40 years and still not see the entire beauty of this country.
The Bahamas has natural beauty, pristine waters, wonderful plant and animal life. But I have to say, I think the beauty of the Bahamas is really the people of the Bahamas.
Of people who are willing to learn, people are willing to find out what they can do to improve not only our lives, but the lives of people who come to visit our shores as well. That's the kind of people we are.
I think that what the world is realizing is that you have these people who are just so incredibly talented, who are not intimidated by change. And so the ability for behaviors to actually adapt and adopt is something that I think that people find exciting.
I think the Bahamas is very well poised for growth, and I think any investor looking to come to the Bahamas should do so and feel and know that we will embrace them with open arms. There's a lot to invest in here, not just within the financial services industry, but across all industries. And certainly I think from here on in, it's only going to get better in the Bahamas.